Hey, why are you not using your pinky? Really?
Cellist 没有用 pinky 的。
有啦。
啊那 ，no excuse 哎，哇，哇是扬琴
player。
哇塞。OK. Hey, excuse me. 哇 ，C minor,
C
minor.
Exotic 嘞。
Sorry.
Okay. Not much of a saint yourself.
So yes, hi everyone.
Hi.
We're back from our Chinese New Year break.
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So welcome to our 26th live session.
Yes.
And my name is Sang Hua.
I'm Eason.
I'm Biyu.
And we're from
Eason
Music. That's right. So before we get on to our topic for today, which is learning chords on the Zhongruan, which is actually very highly requested.
Yes.
Just let's a little bit about Eason Music. So we're primarily a Chinese instrumental shop, and we sell instrument, we do repairs for the instrument, we do lessons for the instrument, we do rental, as well as live performances.
Correct.
Well, with these Chinese instruments.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so live performances
and
is not this live, right?
Live performances and live sessions.
Yeah, so
somehow we talk about
our live sessions.
Yes.
So every fortnight we will be doing a live session on Facebook. So the concept of this live session goes like this. We'll first share about the latest happenings.
Okay.
Then after that we will talk about maybe a topic. Like today's topic will be to share some interesting things, interesting tips, tricks about instruments.
Yes.
Yeah, and sometimes we invite special guests on on our show to talk more about the things that they do, and they'll probably be doing some Chinese orchestra related thing. Yeah, and at the and we also introduce some instruments on our show, and at the end of it we always will have a performance.
Yes. And today's performance will be a secret.
We'll
reveal at the end, near the end. Yeah, so stay tuned for it. We're going to talk about the playing chords on Zhongruan. So,
yes.
As you all know, Song Hua here is a
guitar
brilliant
guitar player.
Yes, he's a brilliant guitar player. And we've been doing live for 26 episodes so far. And people has always been asking, can we do an episode on Zhongruan, especially about playing chords on Zhongruan? So I think the time has come. It has come to fruition.
Yes.
And we would really like to get to learn it, because I'm not a Zhongruan player.
I'm not a Zhongruan player.
But she's a pipa player, so she could pick up really fast. And we have a mysterious guest over here to bring us even more laughter and entertainment. And who else to do that than Rui Ling? She's almost in reach. Rui Ling is back to join us for this episode. Hi, Rui Ling. So Rui Ling, as you all know, she plays the erhu as well as cello for our live session. So are you nervous, or do you think you can pull this off? Like,
I don't know. I'm very bad with chords.
But you're a pianist as well. So chords should come naturally to you.
More classical.
Like G.
No, I play more classical things.
Well, but what do you mean by you are very bad in chords?
Yeah, like what's your concept of chords?
Okay.
Yeah.
My brother, he plays the guitar also.
Okay.
So I
see. Wow, music runs in the family.
But then I don't understand.
Oh.
I cannot understand his score. Like,
yes.
I see him play his
like on the score, there's like those little alphabets, those chord charts, is it?
He got tapped.
Oh, okay, that's something I don't understand also.
Yeah.
I'm tapped out.
Yeah,
so taps is a very
cool.
Easy way of reading guitar notes.
Yes.
I mean, for guitar players.
Yeah, so okay, before we actually jump right into it, right, do you have any disclaimer to tell our audience?
Yes,
today?
Of course.
Because the tuning of the Zhongruan is different from a guitar. So like, is there anything we have to take note of before we start to attempt playing?
Yes, okay, before I start, first I would like to give a disclaimer, or a couple of them.
Okay.
First is, I am not a Zhongruan player. And this
None
is not.
Of us are. Keep that in mind.
This is not a session to teach you how to play the Zhongruan. Okay, the Zhongruan, traditional Zhongruan, has its unique techniques and everything. But I am a guitar player. So what today I'm teaching you is, I managed to find out the different chord shapes on the Zhongruan, and using my experience in playing the ukulele and playing the guitar. So today I'm going to share with you how to form the chords on the Zhongruan, and with that you can accompany any song that you hear on the radio. Yeah.
Simpler chords.
So why can you why do you, when you learn chords, you will be able to play simple, I mean you will be able to play accompaniment songs? Mm-hmm. It's because all songs that you hear on the radio and everywhere, they're all made up of chords. I mean, underlying those notes, there is a certain chord that will fit in with the melody.
Okay.
So some songs is complicated, some songs is very simple.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so today we pick a few simple songs. So once you know the shape of it, okay. I mean, where to hold the chords, and let's say G, then what you need to add would be that's the left hand, the chords.
Okay.
And the right hand, you will need to add some rhythm. Okay.
All right.
So right hand is actually for example, if you sing Happy Birthday, you clap. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Yes, you get the idea. So your right hand is actually to create this clapping rhythm. This is tempo. Yeah. So instead of just you can actually hear the chords instead of just. So what we're trying to achieve now is to learn the left hand, some chords, then right hand, some rhythm. It could be like tick, just simple down stroke. Could be a bit more syncopated.
Okay.
Like tick, tick, yeah. Then yeah. So at the end of today, I mean the last part, I also teach you simple ways of picking, playing broken chords.
Broken chords. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
what's broken chords?
Instead of just a ching, ching.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Sure.
So, without much ado, please pick up your Zhongruan and lesson has started.
So, we have to address Lao Guan as Lao Shi today.
Okay. So, now you have. The Zhongruan. So,
a rare sight.
Today we are going to learn about songs in the key of G.
Okay.
Okay, so G, of course, we will learn the first chord, which is G chord.
Okay.
So, if you have the chord chart, Zheng Xing, would you be kind enough to put the G out? Okay. So, that's G. Okay. So, everybody, try to get a G. If you see the number on the string there, okay, first, how do you read the chord chart? Okay, so the chord chart, right, has four strings, 1, 2, 3, 4.
One is the thinnest one.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the thinnest one would be the one on the, if you look on the right.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah, so it's not a mirror image.
No.
It's not. You know how those dancing videos?
Oh.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying, right? You watch so many K-pop, you confirm no one.
Oh, no, you can see though.
Yeah, you can see the chord, the G chord, okay?
Yeah, from left.
Yeah.
Left. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Mm-hmm. Let's look at G first, okay? So you use your, what you call that? The ring finger and press. Ring finger is preferred, or if you want to use a middle finger, it's fine also.
Okay. Oh.
Yeah, but anyway, this is G. So what you're going to do is, let's give a strum.
Wow.
Yeah, so this is a G chord,
okay?
Then the next chord that we're going to learn is a C chord, but because C chord is, the whole of C chord is very complicated.
On a Zhongruan, is it?
Yeah, not very complicated. You have to bar, and for me, I would like to
simplify
things. So this is called a C9. You just need to press two notes here. If you look at the...
Do we have to play all four strings?
Yes. Yeah. So this is okay. So I'm going to patent this and call this the SWC9 chord. Okay? Because I never seen anybody play. I've never seen anybody play this chord. Okay. So yeah.
I mean, if you can play a C, why would you want to play a C9?
It doesn't resonate.
Hey, why are you not using your pinky?
No strength.
Really?
Chelsea 没有用 pinky
的，有啦。啊那
no excuse 哎，哇哇 I see 杨青 player.
Okay.
So
okay.
We got a C 9.
Playing the right note. This G.
Yeah, this is G.
Okay. C.
Okay.
Yeah. Really? C 9.
哎呦哎呦。 struggle.
Hey, excuse me. Wow, C minor, C minor.
C exotic, leh.
Sorry.
Wait. Okay, you refer to the chord chart. So which finger goes where?
Sorry, yes. Okay. So Rui Ling, you play the G, right? Uh-huh. Then just the next fret will be your
directly down. One fret down,
So one fret down will be the C,
Then yeah. So
like that.
Yeah. So the thing about changing chords is you need to know where to go to the next chord, where your fingers go. You cannot hold this chord, then you release everything in, try to find, what's next? Oh, okay, like that. You must know from here to move to the next chord, what is the most efficient way, which is...
So that's why the G you use third finger.
Yeah.
And then the C you use first and fourth.
Yeah, so you can change it fast, because some... Yeah, you need to change it fast. Okay, so the next chord will be a D chord, alright? D chord, if you see the chord chart, there's an X there, which means that you do not play that note as much as possible, because it's not in the chord. Yeah. So what I would do is, I would use this middle finger here, instead of pointing at people, I would just tap it lightly, so that it doesn't sound... Just touch it lightly, lah.
Wait, so
middle just finger a touch.
Mute. Is the mute it?
Mute the third string.
Fourth. Mute the fourth string.
Because the fourth string, according to the chart, you're not playing it. Yeah. A lot of D's right now.
Okay, let's just play.
So it's next to the G, and then.
Yeah,
same. Like, this one.
So
C and G and... Okay. So let's do this chord sequence of a G, G and a D, and C. Okay, so each chord we will play, it'll be in one bar and we'll play four notes. So we'll play G like 1, 2, 3, 4 and D, D, then C. Another time C, 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 and G, 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 D, 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 C, 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 C,
C. Your C sounds very funny. Oh, 没有力耶.
Okay, can.
Oh, I know already.
You're not pressing down high.
Because she's pulling the string.
Oh, yeah. So, Zhongruan. Yeah, Zhongruan, there's this thing, I think pipa player would relate also. Like, when you first learn the instrument, right, don't tend to, pull on your... Yeah, you tend to pull on the strings also.
Beginner.
Why is it beginner?
No.
Wait, so G, D,
yeah.
And C.
Okay, so this song is... we're going to play the first song, which is the lazy song. All right? So, can you put the lazy song chords on top?
He lazy to do it.
So for this lazy song, we just play the second and the fourth beat. Like dun 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 dun
dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun teach me how to doggy in my castle. I'm the freaking man. Oh, yes.
Okay, here is different already.
Okay. That part, the chord is different already.
Yeah, it's a different chord.
Oh.
So that's how you.
Actually, quite fun.
My hand is also like really painful.
No, because guitar, I'm very used to like this.
I don't know how Zhongruan plays. stand and play 20 minutes.
This is really for people who played Zhongruan for a while and gotten used to the, your body have gotten used to the posture of holding a Zhongruan. Then you attempt this because we are sore.
Yeah, just now I forgot to say, actually, this session is actually for Zhongruan players who want to, you know, use Zhongruan to do something else besides play the traditional Chinese stuff, or also guitar players or ukulele players who want to try, who have this hanging around somewhere, or who like the sound of the zhongruan.
Yeah, but this is for zhongruan, because xiaoruan, the tuning will be different also.
Yeah, but all the techniques and everything is the same. It's just like when you play violin, then you go and play the viola, although not exactly, but you would be able to. Let's not say violin and viola, erhu and gaohu.
Okay.
And erhu and zhonghu. Okay, so yeah, so the next song, let's go to the next song, which also consists of this three chords, which is a campfire song that you always... not that campfire song. Campfire songs, songs that you sing around a campfire, like She'll Be Coming Round the Mountain and When the Saints Go Marching.
Have you ever heard of these songs before, Rui Ling?
Yeah.
Yeah, can you sing? Yeah, prove it, come on.
Wait, I only know the second one. Do I?
You'll be coming round.
Oh, yeah, I know the first one. But then the second one, I'm confused.
And then, when the same, marching in.
I know it's a different name, though. It's just Saints.
Saints.
Oh, maybe, yeah. All right, okay.
Not much of a saint yourself.
Okay, so for this song, since we know the chords already, let's go to a different strumming pattern, which... it's very popular among guitar players and also ukulele players. It's this is the rhythm. Da ta 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 ta. Yeah, so there is a certain stroke to it. So please do not play down, up, down, up, down. Yeah, it's gonna be very how would you play da 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 da? Yes, that's exactly what I said. What I want you to avoid, okay? We want to, because the hand is always moving up and down, so this rhythm, you have to follow the groove of the hand. So if you do it feels very awkward. It's like when you march, then your left
leg
and
right. You keep using left leg too much.
Same.
left.
So you have to do it like a down, down, up, up, down, 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 down, up, up, down, 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 up, up, down. Okay, so let's go through the chords first. See if we can. One, two, three, go. C, G, sorry. G, second G. Third G, going to the D. C, D. Okay, one more time, two.
Are we doing it correctly? At least I think it sounded
right.
Were you looking at our hands?
Okay, I think I will look.
Check.
Okay, one, two, three, go. G. Second G. Third G. And D. And G. And C. And D. And G. Another time. G. 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 And D and G, going to C and D and G. Okay, when the saints, when the saints
go marching in,
when the saints go marching in, G, when I want to be a number,
when the saints go marching in, she'll be coming round the mountain when she comes.
She'll be coming round the mountains when she comes.
She'll be coming down the mountain.
She'll be coming
down
the mountain.
She'll be coming
round the mountain when she comes.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
Everyone quite talented.
Yeah, so you just need to be familiar with the chords and know a strumming pattern, for example, the down, down, up, up, down.
Yeah.
Or you can just strum down strokes. Mm-hmm.
I mean, it sounds very boring, but we're coming round the mountain, let she come.
Very
we're coming round the mountain, let she come.
We're coming down the mountain, let she come down the mountain.
DG.
Oh, okay, that sounds complicated. How did you do that?
Play D and G.
He went down.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's another chord shape of G. G. Yeah.
I'm just doing Tito. Actually, it's correct, right?
Yeah, it's correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
A bit of Zhongruan knowledge. A bit.
Okay.
Alright, so
okay.
These are the like more easy kind of like easy to get.
Yeah, easy to play lah. Yeah, so there are a lot of songs that only have these little chords. So you can go and Google what chords. I mean chords for da 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 song, and you will find all these chords. Then you need to know how to hold. Yeah, these chords on the Zhongruan, which I will have a chord chart and I can share it with all of you.
Yay!
Yeah. So let's moving on to the next one. Let's try to do some picking. So we're going to play broken chords. So what you need to do is you look at the chord chart and you play the first note would be the one that is the lowest. So if you see G and you can. Yeah, then the next note you can play the bottom two strings.
Okay, why am I holding my pick?
Hey, you use the pick,
Oh.
Yeah.
She'll be coming round the mountain.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
So, the next chord that we're going to learn is the E minor. So
E
can
minor.
You all try?
Try G major 7.
What G major 7? E minor.
E minor. It's like the D, but 搬过来了.
Yeah.
So
D, yeah, it's like a D, but 你就搬过来. Then you see an A5, right?
A5.
Oh, damn.
Do we one finger press all?
I
use three. La.
Yeah. Use three. Yeah. Is it invisible though? To use one.
Is it what?
Which finger is the most outside one? The
It's better to do it this way, yeah.
Like this?
Yeah.
Oh, I was doing this?
Yeah, I was doing this.
Damn it.
Yeah. I'll hit my ukulele students if they do this.
Oh.
Hit the hand.
Wow, I'm silly, Ukulele student.
Yes. So that's A5. Now very quickly, let's go to G/B.
What does that mean, G/B? We're still playing a G chord, is it?
B
yeah.
Minor.
It's actually a inversion chord, the second inversion of G. So G is like that, right? Then B, you need to have the B that is the lowest note, which is yeah.
Can yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, then the B flat.
Then the B flat,
like B flat.
Yeah. Then just.
Ooh, so spicy.
Yeah.
Okay, but we have to emphasize on the lower notes, lah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. What was that?
Okay.
I mean, Yang Qing also got this kind of thing.
Okay, so the A5, why not don't press 3, just press this 2.
Which 2?
The last 2? The last 2?
The top 2. Yeah.
Then there will be a diminished.
No, it's a 7.
Yeah, there's a 7 in inside.
Yeah. It's G note, G note is a 7.
Yeah.
Then,
a, because G and A is 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, then there is
so
A, B, C, D. And there's also a 4th there. Okay, but never mind.
It's too complicated.
We just do. We just do simple things that don't need us to press until our fingers are.
Then G and A, it's a 7. 7.
Okay,
am I
right? Okay, let's go to the next song.
Okay.
It's a little bit more complicated.
But there's a G major 7 there.
We just play G, lah, okay?
Okay.
We have time now, okay? Hey, where's the.
What is it? Oh. What you do? Okay.
Can I? You can look.
One more finger on top.
Yeah.
Eh?
Yeah, this is G major 7.
Okay. Mm-hmm. But how do we play a broken chord? Like, which are the strings we use?
Yeah.
You see, the characteristics of this major 7 is here. So if you are going to just pluck this string and you're going to miss out this string, then it wouldn't sound like seven. Major 7.
Okay.
So you might want to include this.
Ooh.
There's another note, okay? You know, like this note is actually this note, right? So you can actually do this. So instead of
you add the octave up, lah.
Yeah.
Let's try this. Wow.
Yeah, let's try this a bit more challenging song. Can we put the chords to this song is called 踮.
E minor is what?
Like D, but then you move in a bit.
Okay. Yeah. Oh my god.
Okay.
Okay.
So we'll start with G major 7. Okay. Let's do it together. 1, 2, 3, 4. G major 7. G major 7. Wait.
E minor already.
Oh, okay, so you have to play two times for one bar, like OG, second time,
four,
one, two, three, four, then E minor. Then go to the C9, then B, then A, then D. Another time.
I just jumped
in. You can relax. Okay, oh God, let's just try again. The verse 1, 2, 3,
and
go.
And.
2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, E minor. 1, 2, 3, and change C. Change to B. And it's 5. Go to the chorus and G. Then E. Then C. And B. A. And D. And
G.
E minor. Then Gary for C, going to a B, then going one fret down again, B flat, then D, A, and D.
Yes.
Somewhat.
Okay, so let's sing this song. I'm not, no, I mean, B, can you help to sing while you play? I can hum a 1, 2, 3. Oh, this song is called 踮起脚尖.
Yeah.
What's that? 1. 2,
oh my God,
3,
okay.
4. E minor. C. Chorus.
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 Go down one fret. One more fret. Yes.
Because you guys were singing with like plucking, I'm like, where is everything?
No, you just need to get used to it. I just like when you play ukulele also, right? Or ukulele.
Ukulele,
yeah.
Oh, exposed. Oh. She sometimes would sing live on her Instagram at night, late night. Back then, I'm not sure about now. Yeah, it was actually really fun. So, I'm pretty sure there's more to just this. Like three songs that we learned so far.
Mm-hmm.
But do you think it has covered, we have covered most of the basics?
Yes, actually, if you know all these chords, you can play a lot of songs already.
Oh.
I mean, especially a lot of Chinese songs.
The chord progression is like quite similar, is it?
Yes, quite similar to the 踮起脚尖 and for English songs, a lot of songs is like G, D,
C,
E minor, and C. And just repeat.
A minor, 没有.
A minor 比较少.
Okay.
But also have la. You just need to know.
Interesting.
Yeah, like
grab your Zhongruan now.
For example, I'm yours. You know, a lot of song. You know that exists.
I'm yours again.
Right? I'm yours. Doesn't need to. But first, you must get a key correct first, right?
Yeah. Anything else
you
can play, just change the key.
Yeah. So this one, lesson one, is just all for G, like tuning to
lesson
G.
One? There's more lessons.
I mean, for today's introductory lesson. Yeah. So,
yeah. Okay. So, yeah. So,
thank you very much.
Today is only for songs in the key of G. Mm. So, there are some songs, if you play G, it might not suit your vocal range.
Yeah
so you might.
I know that guitar does couple also, right? But so Zhongruan, I'm pretty sure if you couple it, the string
break. No. But you know, you can just learn other keys also. Okay. Yeah, so for other songs, you can just learn the series of chords in, for example, in the key of D. La. I mean, if you know G and D, you can get your way around it. La, because they're like in the center. So if G is too high, then you try a D.
Transpose it down.
Yeah.
Then it's not advisable to tune the strings to fit the key also.
No.
You don't do that on guitar also, right?
Yeah, you don't do that.
You might just risk breaking the string or getting the string too loose also.
Yeah, too loose and a lot of buzzing. Okay. So, yes.
Thank you, 老师.
Thank you, 下课.
谢谢老师. All right, so thank you, Rui Ling, for joining us for this very short but informative Zhongruan chord session.
Crash course.
Yes, so we'll see you again. We'll see you later for our last performance.
Yep.
Okay.
Would you?
Yes.
Thank you once again, Rui Ling,
for gracing, for showing your face.
Bye.
Yes.
Yeah. So, for the next segment, we're just going to show you some of the things that came in, over the weeks.
Mainly this brand called Insongland.
Yeah.
So, what I'm holding right now is the, small child size pipa. From Insongland, this is Ingmu Ertong Pipa. I'm not wearing nails, I'm just using my nails itself. And it sounds really actually quite good. It has a very hollow sound. So if like, for child size pipa is mainly for kids that is around 7 to 8 years old because they are not of the height and they have small fingers. So they will start off with like a mini or like small size, child size pipa first. Then after, and it's quite light as compared to the Shanghai Dunhuang Ertong Pipa. So if you have like child at home who wants to pick up the pipa, you can actually consider to have the Insongland child size pipa. And other than the child size pipa, we also have the
adult size
or the original size pipa.
Yeah, so what wood is this?
Heitan. Yes, this is Heitan and this is Hongmu Pipa. So for this two, it has really nice carving. Even for the child size pipa, it has a very nice carving behind it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not really sure, like I only can read a few of the words. But it's really nice carved over here. And Heitan it's kind of on the heavier end, while the Hongmu pipa it's on the lighter end, but it has a very nice sound to it itself. It is not tuned properly. So I think if you are looking for a more bright tone where it resonates really well, but you do not have the budget to actually purchase like a Beijing maker pipa, you can actually consider the Yingsong Lan pipa, because it sounds rather quite similar, but it does has a hollowness to it. It projects really well as well.
Well, maybe you can do pipa chords also.
Well, maybe next time. Yeah, I need to research on that. Okay, so these are the three pipas that we just brought in, and the next one will be the sanxian.
Oh, okay,
yeah,
okay.
I put this back.
Okay, so we always had the sanxian, but actually they are from this brand called Raoyang, Beifang, Raoyang Beifang. So, and also we had the synthetic skin sanxian, but for today we'll be showcasing the real snake, the genuine snake skin sanxian by Yingsong Lan, am I right?
Yes, correct.
Yes. Yeah, so what wood is this? Yeah, so there's a very rather distinct red hue to the wood. And I do not play the sanxian, do you?
I don't play the sanxian.
Yeah, so it's, do you play the sanxian, oh master?
I can play the sanxian, I mean.
Yeah, it sounds, what do you think?
It sounds like a sanxian.
Like it's very bright, but I think it has the very rich sanxian nasally snake skin tone to it.
And sanxian itself actually comes in three different sizes, but this is the
da sanxian. So there's three small, middle, and medium and large. So this is the large sanxian. And it's actually quite light.
Yes, it's actually light as well. So the next one and the last one will be the zhonghu that we brought in from Yingsong Lan, which is over here.
Zhonghu then is really up to.
Yes. This is Hei Tan Mu.
Black Sandalwood Zhonghu by Yingsong Lan. Yeah, so ever since Yang Qing that we tried out Yingsong Lan, we really start to bring in more and more Yingsong Lan brands, and they're really quite up to our expectations, or even exceeds our expectations for that price range also.
Yeah, so for this Zhonghu, is actually very easy to play, very responsive.
So for our viewers who don't know what a zhonghu is a lower range kind of, as in in terms of pitching, lower range erhu. So there's erhu, zhonghu, and gaohu. Gaohu will be the soprano sort of range for the, and usually zhonghu is used in orchestras. But there are solo pieces written for zhonghu, and there are people who's experimenting with zhonghu also because of its very low mellow tone.
Yeah, a lot of people like the tone of zhonghu because
it's been described as the voice of a very elderly son. So is that all?
Yeah, that's all we have brought to introduce to everyone this week.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we'll be listing all these instruments on our website. So web store. So do look for it.
Left in the description once the instruments are ready on our web store.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
All right. So
let's come to the last segment of our live session.
Yes. Ooh.
So today we're going to present to you a song
that we actually played just now.
Yes.
Oops.
So we're going to play 踮起脚尖. It's actually a song written by Tanya, and who is the singer? I cannot remember the name.
Hong Peiyu.
Okay.
No. Yes.
Hong Peiyu.
Yes. I think it is one of the songs of a Taiwanese drama series. I cannot remember what
Someone introduced me this song. Then I'm like, oh, okay. But I haven't watched the drama before.
Okay.
So, we're not going to play the Zhongruan, of course.
Yeah.
I'll be off to the Yangqing.
Yeah.
But Lao Ban will be using a Zhongruan.
Yes.
And to join us for this final performance, we'll have Rui Ling back with us. And also Zheng Xing will be playing the erhu. A long time never see his face already.
Yeah.
And of course, we'll have Biyu on the vocals. So stay tuned while we set up for the song 踮起脚尖爱.
Yes.
Bravo!
Wow, wow!
Sukoi!
Sukoi ne!
Bagus, baik! Alamak!
Alright, so that concludes today's session.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Yes, and we hope you learn a bit more about how you play the chords on the Zhongruan. So we have to thank you to our very own Songhua on preparing on this very interesting segment.
Yes,
and
yes.
Thank you, Rui Ling, for appearing on our show once again to learn the Zhongruan with us and also to play the erhu for this very lovely song called
踮起脚尖爱.
So don't forget to subscribe, comment and like on our various social media platform. And we'll see you again for our next live session, which will be a Chinese episode. And speaking of Chinese, if you're wondering, our Chinese New Year episode for last live session will be uploaded tonight at 7:30. So do look out for it. Today is 元宵节, Chap Gome after all. So bye-bye and enjoy your Friday evening and your weekends.
Bye.